मेज इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सीरियल क्रॉप्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड एंड कंट्रीब्यूट्स टू फूड सिक्योरिटी इन द मोस्ट ऑफ द डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज. मेज इज नॉट ओनली यूज फॉर ह्यूमन फूड, एनिमल एंड पोल्ट्री फीड, बट ऑल्सो वाइडली यूज फॉर कॉर्न स्टार्च इंडस्ट्री, कॉर्न ऑयल प्रोडक्शन, बेबी कॉर्न्स एंड मैनी मोर थिंग्स. बैंडेड लीफ एंड सीथ ब्लाइट इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट डिजीज ऑफ मेज विच इज कॉज्ड बाय अ डिवास्टेटिंग फंगस रेजिटोनिया सोलेनाई. दिस डिजीज स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द लोएस्ट सीथ विच इज इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द सॉइल एंड एक्सटेंड अप टू ईयर ऑफ द मेज प्लांट. The symptoms of this disease are characterized by the presence of alternate bleached area on leaf sheath and on the leaves. The initial symptoms of this disease are irregular water-soaked straw-colored lesions on leaf sheath and stalks. On stalks, olive green and brown large continuous patches can be seen, as you can see in this video also. On young lesions of this fungus, you can notice the white mycelium. These are the white mycelium of this fungus. If you will closely observe these lesions, you will notice the aggregating mycelium, which will form the scrotum of this fungus, as you can see in this video also. The scrotum is a compact mass of hardened fungal mycelium which contains reserve food material. It is formed by the aggregation of mycelium and it is a survival structure of Rhizoctonia solanae under extreme environmental conditions. Scrotia initially are white in color and later turn to dark brown when they become mature. Scrotia are produced superficially on or near the lesions and are the primary means for the survival of this fungus during off-season periods. These scrotia can survive for several years in the soil and in the infected plant parts and can attack several weed hosts and cause infection. This disease is also known as banded sclerosal disease because it is banded in appearance and it contains numerous sclerosal bodies on the infected plant parts. So that's why it is also known as banded sclerosal disease. These are the mature dark brown sclusia of Rhizoctonia solanae, which are adhered on the infected plant parts. Actually, this disease starts on the leaf sheath and stalks, and can extend up to years. You can see the banded patterns on the maize leaf along with the sclusia. This fungus also causes infection on husk leaves, silk and seeds of the maize. On maize seeds, this fungus produces irregular white spots, which is surrounded by reddish brown margin. These seeds are wrinkled or chaffy, dry and light in weight. As you can see in this video also, the milky white spots on the maize seeds. This is the fungal colony on the PDA medium. This fungus is identified by branching pattern, which occurs at right angle or 90 degree. This fungus also causes infection on roots, both primary and crown roots, as you can see in this video also. This fungus can cause 100% losses in the first week of infection if the temperature is about 28 degree centigrade and relative humidity is up to 90%. These conditions favors rapid disease development. If rainfall occurs during this period, this disease develops very rapidly. For management, I will suggest only clean your field before sowing the maize. Be sure there shouldn't be any weeds around your field which can harbor this fungus. You can grow resistant varieties. If needed, you can go for fungicide. Thanks for watching this video.